Good morning, students. So continuing our fourth chapter, chapter number 4, Tick, Tick, Tick. In the previous classes, you have learned how to read the time. Let us revise. The dial of a clock is divided into 12 big divisions and 60 small divisions. The long hand, the longer hand is called the minute hand, and the shorter hand is called the hour hand. In these slides, we have to learn how long the minute hand take to move from one place to another. In this slide, we are seeing two clocks. In first clock, we are seeing that the hour hand is in between 4 and 5, and the minute hand is at 7. In the second clock, we are seeing that the hour hand is in between 4 and 5, and the minute hand is at 10. So you have to see, you have to check the minute hand. How long will it take to move from 7 to 10? So when it moves from 7 to 8, it will take 5 minutes. From 8 to 9, again 5 minutes. From 9 to 10, again 5 minutes. So 5 plus 5 plus 5 equal to 15 minutes. So the time duration between 4:35 to 4:50 is 15 minutes. In this question, again we have to check the time taken by the minute hand. First of all, check the hour hand. In the first figure, it is near to 4. In the second figure, it is on 4. Then the minute hand, in the first clock, it is on 8. And in the second clock, the minute hand is on 12. So the minute hand has to move from 8 to 12. So check it. From 8 to 9, minute hand is moved for 5 minutes. From 9 to 10, it will take 5 minutes. From 10 to 11, it will take 5 minutes. From 11 to 12, again it will take 5 minutes. So total time taken by minutes is 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 equal to 20. So the time between 3:40 to 4 o'clock is 20 minutes. In the next, again you have to check how long will it take the minute hand to move from. In the first clock, the time is 6:05. In the second clock, the time is 6:15. So minute hand has to move from 1 to 3. So 1 to 2, it will take 5 minutes. 2 to 3, again 5 minutes. 5 into 2 equal to 10. So the duration between 6:05 to 6:15 is 10 minutes. Again, two clocks are given. In the first clock, the time is 7:10. And in the second clock, the time is 7:45. So the minute hand has to move from 2 to 9. From 2 to 3, it will take 5 minutes. From 3 to 4, again it will take 5 minutes. 4 to 5, again 5 minutes. 5 to 6, 5 minutes. 6 to 7, 5 minutes. 7 to 8, 5 minutes. And 8 to 9, 5 minutes. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5, total 35 minutes. So the time duration between 7:10 to 7:45 is 35 minutes. In the first clock, the time is 7:10, and in the second clock, the time is 7:45. So the time duration between 7:10 to 7:45 is 35 minutes. Now the next draw where the hands will be. The time is given 20 minutes after 6 o'clock. First of all, check the hour hand. It is after 6 o'clock. After 6 o'clock means you have to draw the hour hand after 6. In between 6 and 7. And the minute hand 20 minutes. So you can divide 20 by 5 equal to 4. So the minute hand will be at 4 and the hour hand is after 6. And the time is 6:20. You can see, you can check the hands hour as well as minute hand. You can check in this clock. The time is now 6:20. Again, you have to draw the hands 30 minutes after 8 o'clock. Now, the hour hand is after 8. It's in between 8 and 9. And minute hand is at 30 minutes, means 30 divided by 5 equal to 6. 30 divided by 5, what will be the answer? Yes, 6. So, minute hand is at 6. And hour hand is between 8 and 9. And by looking at the clock, we can say the time. It is 8:30. Again, you have to draw hands 10 minutes after 7 o'clock. After 7 o'clock. So hour hand will be after 7. And the minute hand is at 10 minutes. 10 matlab. 10 divided by 5 equal to 2. The minute hand will be at 2 and hour hand after 7. So you can check hour hand as well as you can check the minute hand. And the time which is in this clock is 7:10. You can read the time. It is 7:10. Again, 15 minutes after 5 o'clock. After 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock ke baad mein, just near to 5, means in between 5 and 6, our hour hand will be. And minute hand, 15 minutes. Means 15, if we divide 15 by 5, the answer is 3. So minute hand 3 pe ho jayega, or hour hand after 5. You can see 5:15, the time is 5:15. You can see the hand, you can see the drawing of the hands, hour hand as well as the minute hand. Now the question is, Ashish, school starts at 7 o'clock and the school assembly continues till 7:15. How much time school assembly takes? Ashish school, it starts at 7 o'clock. In the first clock, you can read the time, it is 7 o'clock. And the school assembly continues till 7:15. And in the second clock, you can read the time, it is 7:15. Now, how much time school assembly take? Okay. In the first clock, the time is 7 o'clock. In the second clock, the time is 7:15. So, the time duration for the assembly is from 7 to 7:15. Again, you can calculate. You can just take the minute hand. From 12, the minute hand has to move from 12 to 3. It's 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes again. 5 plus 5 plus 5 equal to 15. So, the school assembly takes 15 minutes. Next question. The lunch break is from 10:15 to 10:45. How much time is for lunch break? So, lunch break starts from 10:15 and it ends to 10:45. So, you have to calculate the time duration for lunch break. In the first clock, you can see the time is 10:15. In the second clock, you can see the time is 10:45. So, 10:45 minus 10:15. The answer is, tell the answer, calculate the answer, or you can check the answer by moving the minute hand. The minute hand has to move from 3 to 9. 3 to 4, 5 minutes. 4 to 5, 5 minutes. 5 to 6, 5 minutes. 6 to 7, 5 minutes. 7 to 8, 5 minutes. And 8 to 9, 5 minutes. 6 are numbers the minute hand has to cross. 6 into 5 equal to 30. So lunch break is for 30 minutes. So the next question is, the last period is games period, which is from 12:30 to 1 o'clock. What is its duration? Again, you are seeing two clocks. Read the time in the first clock, it is 12:30. And in the second clock, it is 1 o'clock. Ab kitna time duration hai? Games period ka from 12:30 to 1 o'clock. So the minute hand has to move from 6 to 12. 6 numbers the minute hand has to cross. 6 into 5 equal to 30 minutes. The games period is for 30 minutes. I hope, student, you have studied how to read the time in the clock and how to check the time taken by minute hand to move from one place to another. Thank you, student. Goodbye.